My name is Emmanuel Coron. I am a gastroenterologist working in the University Hospital of Nantes, France. And it's my pleasure to present you our study entitled Colonic Endoscopic Full Thickness Biopsies from the Neuropathological Analysis of the Myenteric Plexus to the Functional Assessment of Neuromuscular Transmission. Pathophysiological mechanisms involved in severe motility disorders are crucial for the better management of our patients and also to identify novel therapeutic targets. Currently, the gold standard technique to access tissues is surgical biopsies. However, the development of interventional endoscopic techniques now allows to perform endoscopic full thickness resection. These endoscopic full thickness resections have mainly been applied to precancerous lesions and cancerous lesions, and very few data exist regarding the possibility to study the enteric nervous system. Therefore, the aim of our study performed in animals was to develop and assess the possibility to study the myenteric plexus and perform functional analysis of the circular muscle on endoscopically obtained full thickness biopsies. Our study was performed in the animal facility of the University Hospital of Nantes in 6 pigs. Under general anesthesia and after surgically assisted preparation, the animals underwent a rectosigmoidoscopy. For each animal, 3 endoscopic full thickness biopsies were obtained at different sites, respectively 25, 30 and 35 cm from the anal verge. The endoscopic full thickness resections were performed using the DUET mucosectomy system, and the samples were immediately processed to be microdissected and either stained to perform immunohistochemical analysis of all mounds of myenteric plexus, either underwent functional assessment using electrical field stimulation and cardiacal application. Our results showed that adequate specimens were obtained in all cases, and the area of the mucosa was approximately 4.6 square centimeters, where the area of the muscularis was approximately 2.1 square centimeters. The myenteric plexus analysis on whole mounds using immunohistochemical methods showed that it was possible to visualize and characterize approximately 14 myenteric ganglia representing 1,500 myenteric neurons per sample, and the functional analysis of the circular muscle showed that electrical field stimulation induced a B-contractile response while carbuccal induced a dose-dependent contractile response of circular muscle strips. In conclusion, our study performed in animals showed that it is possible to use endoscopically obtained specimens to perform both myenteric plexus analysis from whole mounds and also to obtain functional informations on the circular muscle. And we think that provided this technique is shown to be safe, it might be used in humans in the clinical settings and provide better insight in pathophysiological studies and also future therapeutic studies.